everyone. Today I am going to discuss about the medical surgical nursing 2 for the GNM second year. So in that we are going to discuss about the unit 9, that is nursing management of patient with the musculoskeletal disorders. So in that we are going to discuss about the CAST application. So CAST application is today topic, and the CAST application means there is a white powder and there is a white powder that sets to a hot solid when mixed with water. So the CAST application means there is a the CAST can be applied to the affected limb for the immobilization. So in the during the any fractures or the any ligamental problems and the any joint problems, the CAST can be applied to the affected limb and to support the affected limb and for the immobilization of the limb. So how it will make means there is a CAST application, it is become white powder that sets to a hot solid when mixed with water. So the CAST application, it can be made by using the some powder. So the powder, it is become and it is become hard or solid when mixed with the water. So the powder is become hard or solid when it is mixed with the water and used for making sculptures and cast. So it can be the cast and the cast application, it can be used for the making the sculptures and the cast. So sculptures means there is a plastic materials and there is a cast. So the cast, it can be applied to the affected limbs. So the cast powder, the cast application, it includes the white powder and it become hard and it can be mixed with the water. By mixing with the water, the powder become hard and solid and it can be used to making the sculptures and the cast. So the plastic materials and the cast, and in this it can be, the powder can be used and for setting the broken bones. So for the broken bones, the cast can be applied to the broken bones or the affected limbs, and it is usually hemihydrate of calcium sulfate. So hemihydrate means there is a half of the water and half of the powder can be mixed. So in this usually hemihydrate of calcium sulfate, so the powder, it consists of the gas and it is, that is calcium sulfate. So the powder, it includes the making of the cast and the powder is become calcium sulfate. So the powder can be mixed with the water and it is become hard and solid. So it is become hemihydrate. Hemihydrate means there is a half of the water and half of the powder, that is calcium sulfate powder, can be used for the cast applied to the affected bone or broken bones. And the hard plaster produced when this powder is mixed with water. So when the calcium sulfate powder is mixed with the water and it is become hard, and then we can apply to the affected limb or the broken bones for the supporting or the immobilization. So it is about the CAST application. So CAST application, it is become white powder and that sets to a hard solid when it is mixed with the water and used for making sculptures and cast and for setting the broken bones. It is usually hemihydrate of calcium sulfate, and the hard plaster produced when this powder is mixed with the water. So when the powder, calcium sulfate powder, is mixed with the water and it is become hard and solid, then we can apply to the affected limb. So it is about the cast application. And next one is the uses. So what are the uses for the cast application, we will see. And the first one is pain relief and the reduction of swelling. So the cast can be applied to the affected limb or the affected ligaments and the affected joints. So by using this cast, and we can reduce the pain of the patient, and also it can be used to reduce the swelling. So only the cast application is temporary treatment for the affected bone. So only it can be relieves the pain and it can be reduce the swelling of the affected limb, and it is become only temporary relief for the patient. And next one is immobilization of the joint. So the cast application can be affected joint. So by this cast application, and we can immobilize the affected part. So we can limited the movements of the affected bone, and only it can be supports to the affected joint for the immobilization of a joint. Next one is plaster is applied to maintain the reduction of the fragments. So there is a reduction of the fragments. So by the plaster applied, and there is a reduction of the fragments. So the plaster can be applied to the affected limb to the reduce the any fragments. And next one is external splint for the blocking movements in case of nerve and tendon repair. So the external splint, so at the affected area the external splint can be applied for blocking the movements. So to restrict the movement, the external splint can be used for the restrict the movements. So if the patient having any tendon damage or the nerve damage or any repair has occurred, and the external splint can be used for the blocking the movement. And next one is equipments. So the there is a it includes the different types includes there is a equipments. So stock in it, so stock in it, it is a one type of the cast material, and stock in it, it is usually the first layer applied over the area of the cast. So if you are taking the cast, and the there is a first layer the stock in it. So the over the area of the cast, and the stock in it is become first layer of the cast, and it can be used in acute fracture treatment if restricted, it restrict the swelling. So the stock in it, it mostly used in the acute fracture. So the small injuries, small fractures, the stock in it can be used. It is the first layer of the cast area, and it can be used to reduce the swelling of the affected limb. So it is about the stock in it. Stock in it, it is become the layer, first layer of the first layer of the cast area, and it can be used in the small fractures, and it can be used to reduce the swelling. So next one is the webrille. So webrille means there is a width from 5 to 15 centimeters. So it is become webrille the cast. It is also one of the cast, and it is become 5 to 15 centimeters in width and smallest one, and it is easiest to work. So it is very easy process to apply the cast, and it is become 5 to 15 centimeters width, and it is become small, and the webrille can be used in the upper extremity damage. So if the upper extremity fractures, the webrille can be used, and it is become 5 to 10 centimeters webrille used in the upper extremity fractures. So in the upper extremity if any fractures, and the webrille is used, that is 5 to 10 centimeters, and there is a 10 to 15 centimeters used for the lower extremities. So in the lower extremities if there any fracture or any damage, and there is a webrille can be used, that is 10 to 15 centimeters in width. And next one is plaster of Paris. So the plaster of Paris, it is most commonly used casting material. So the mostly the fractures in the fractures and the mostly uses the plaster of Paris. So the plaster of Paris, and it commonly used for the fractures, and it will feel hard within 4 hours. So in the plaster of Paris the powder, calcium sulfate powder, can be used, and when it is mixed with the water, it is become hard, and it can be applied to the affected limb, and there is a and it will feel become hard in the 4 minutes. So when it is mixed with the water, it is become hard within 4 minutes, and Next one is it takes 24 hours for drying. So it is about the plaster of Paris and it is mostly used in the fractures. So the plaster of Paris is mostly used in the fractures. And next one is bucket. So the bucket should be filled with water and at or below the room temperature. So the bucket can be filled with the water. It is kept in the room temperature, that is room temperature between 20 to 22 degree Celsius. So below the room temperature and the bucket should be filled with water, it keep in the room temperature, and there is a cooler water increases the risk of burning the patient. So and cooler water means if the water is become cool and the cast or the plaster of Paris and it can be soaked into the water and we can remove and squeeze and then apply to the skin affected limb. So the bucket consists of it includes the cool water and it kept in the room temperature, and the cooler water it can reduce the irritation of the skin and as the plaster sets. So then the plaster can be applied to the affected limb. So it is about the equipments of the cast application. And next one is procedure. So the procedure, it includes the to prepare plaster of Paris bandage, use dry cotton, gauze and bandage 500 centimeters long and 15 centimeters wide. So first we should prepare the plaster of Paris. So plaster Paris, how it will prepare means there is a calcium sulfate powder we will take and it can be mixed with the water and then it is become hard. So when it is mixed with the water, the powder is become hard and the solid. So and first we should prepare the plaster of Paris bandage and the use dry cotton or gauze. So we should use the cotton or gauze and bandage should be 5 centimeters long and 15 centimeters wide. So the bandage should be 500 centimeters long and the 15 centimeters wide. And next one is unroll a portion of the bandage on a dry table with a smooth top. So first we should, after preparing of the plaster of Paris, and the plaster should be unroll a portion of the bandage. So the bandage should be unrolled. It can be spread over the table, it is become softened, and then apply the plaster powder eventually to the surface. So the bandage should be unrolled and it can be spread over the soft area of the table. So after spreading of the bandage, and first we have prepared the plaster of Paris. So after preparing of the plaster of Paris, and we can apply on the surface of the bandage. So first we should prepare the plaster of Paris, and then we can take the bandage and we can unroll and we can spread on the soft table, and then the plaster of Paris can be applied over the surface of the bandage. And next one is clean the skin and apply dressing to any wounds. So first after preparing the plaster of Paris, and we can clean the skin and apply dressing to any wounds. So first before applying the cast application or the plaster of Paris, first we should clean the skin and then apply the dressing where the wounds can be present, and apply the stocking net and to the extremity avoiding wrinkles. So if there is any possibility of the availability of the stocking net, and there is a first layer of the cast, and it can be padded with the cotton and then applied over the affected limb. So the wrinkle should not be present in the bandage. So it is become very soft and should not avoid the wrinkles of the bandage, and it can be applied over the affected area. And next one is soak the plaster roll in a plain containing water at room temperature and don't use in the warm water. So after preparing the plaster of Paris, and it can be soaked into the cool water, and it can be don't use the warm water. So if you are using the warm water, it can be irritated to the skin of the patient. So because of this, we should avoid the irritation of the skin, and we should use the cool water for soaking the plaster of Paris. So after soaking into the water, and we should remove the bandage from the water, and it can be squeezed properly. So after soaking, and we should remove the bandage from the water, and we can squeeze. And next, while applying the plaster, and hold the relevant part of the body steady in the correct position. So while after removing the plaster of Paris, and we can apply over the skin. So while applying the plaster, and the part of the relevant part of the body, means which part is affected, and that part is become steady in a correct position. So it should be in a correct position while applying the plaster of Paris. So it is very important to the affected part of the body become steady in the correct position while applying the plaster of Paris. And next one is, apply the plaster, leave 3 cm of padding at the upper and the lower margins. So while applying the plaster of Paris, and upper and the lower side, it is become 3 cm become loose the plaster of Paris. So by this we can reduce the irritation of the skin. So there is a, apply the plaster, leave 3 cm padding at the upper and lower margins of the cast to protect the skin from the irritation. So the plaster of Paris becomes 3 cm loose, and it can be reduce the skin irritation. And next one is, complete drying taken 24 hours. So advise the patient to take care. So after applying the plaster of Paris, it is become dry up to after the 24 hours. So and we should advise the patient to take care of the plaster of Paris. So it is become wet, and we should advise the patient to take care of the plaster of Paris, and it takes to dry about 24 hours. So it is about the cast application. Thank you.